The Rehabilitation Institute of Chicago exists to help people who have any kind of disability become functional members of society again. We're focusing not only on recovery, but our research is focusing on minimalizing the effects of whatever disabling disease they have by using the best science that we have available today. Despite the best rehabilitation care we can possibly give, only about 50% of stroke survivors recover full use of their arm.
A stroke results in an injury to a particular area of the brain. And when we're talking about individuals that have difficulty using the motor area of the brain, what we've found is that there are areas of the brain, usually where the lesion is, that are less active than they used to be. And there are actually areas of the brain on the opposite hemisphere, so the healthy area of the brain, that is more active than it used to be.
There's some basic science research out there that has demonstrated that if you actually stimulate the surface or cortex of the brain, you can actually modulate its ability to rewire itself. Fortunately, Nexstim has made a navigated brain stimulator.
Navigated brain stimulation is the combination of an individual's own pictures of their brain with transcranial magnetic stimulation. So you're navigating with their own images to get exactly over where you want, and then using magnets from outside the brain and generating just a little bit of electrical current that activates a particular area of that person's brain.
So we designed a study where we used a low frequency of navigated brain stimulation, which if you apply it to the non-injured hemisphere of patients with stroke, will actually downregulate the excitability of the brain. In doing so, that actually has this interesting effect of upregulating the excitability of the injured side of the brain.
For a given individual, we have their MRI or pictures of their own brain loaded. And then what we need to do is tell the system where their brain is in space. If I know where their head is and I know where their brain is inside the head, I can put all of those things together so that when I'm navigating with my coil, I'm not just moving over top of their scalp, but I know what area of their brain is underneath that scalp and therefore underneath that stimulator.
We were able to get funding through Nexstim, who provided us with the equipment and support for performing this study. Having that in place, we were able to begin recruiting patients. We used a sham stimulation protocol to treat 1/3 of the patients so that we could compare stimulation versus no stimulation. What we thought we would do is see if we could modulate the cortex of patients with stroke right before they go to therapy and determine if we could get better functional outcome.
One of the nice things about the research study that we worked on is that we did work in a multidisciplinary team. And so we were able to really use technology integrated into interventions that we know are effective. So task-specific, intensive training. So it's something that is feasible not only for the clinicians, but also for the patients. It doesn't add necessarily a lot of time in addition to the therapy that they're already receiving.
The Nexstim machine is amazing. I think I've improved because I've gotten the instant feedback. It becomes easier for the therapist, the physical therapist and occupational therapist, to manipulate those systems based on what they've learned from this Nexstim machine.
At 6 months, 80% of the stimulated patients achieve the ability to function at a clinically important higher level versus the sham patients, of which only about 50% were able to maintain a clinically important level of improvement.
It has helped me greatly. I can reach, I can, when I grasp things, I have more control over them in whatever way that I want to move them. It's immeasurable, the progress that I've made.
Since NBS, I've gone back to work. I've since gone into private practice. I've got a new fast car that I'm driving. I think participating in this study, this research, has just made me a healthier minded person as well as physically.
We are now proceeding to a multi-center clinical trial. And when we're done with it, we think we'll have sufficient evidence as to whether or not this is truly a therapeutic tool that should be used clinically or not.
It takes the combination of really good technology, really good science, and really good clinical work. What we need is the good rehab, the fantastic mechanisms of the people that are really good at what they do. Our therapists are key, our clinicians are key. What we're trying to do with these types of technologies is to increase their effectiveness.
The technology out there is showing that we are able to actually modulate brain healing. And I think this is a way for the future. And we're going to see brain stimulation potentially used in other diagnostic categories, including traumatic brain injury, Parkinson's disease, multiple sclerosis. So I think we have a really wide open arena for testing out whether or not this kind of technology can make big differences in people's lives.